A year ago, the Department of Energy made a commitment. A commitment that they, in coordination with key industry players, would lead the analysis of a long-term future for wind power in the United States. They were happy to report preliminary findings of the benefits, challenges, and realities that will face wind energy for the next 30-plus years in this country at the Wind Power Conference in May 2014. The approach for the Wind Vision Study was to develop a robust analytical framework that informs decisions concerning wind power's role in the country's energy future using credible, transparent data and analytical methods. Wind is already a significant portion of our U.S. energy mix. As of year-end 2013, wind supplied over 4% of all electricity demand, with 61 gigawatts installed across 39 states. The original DOE report published in 2008, 20% Wind Energy by 2030, studied a scenario where wind power's national installed fleet by 2013 was 48 gigawatts. The nation has exceeded that scenario with a cumulative installed capacity of 61 gigawatts of wind power by year-end 2013. Wind is a mainstream energy source, and its benefits are spread across the nation. As a clean energy source, wind has already helped the nation reduce its greenhouse gas, water, and air pollution footprint from the power sector. The 96 million metric tons of avoided CO2 in 2013 are the equivalent to taking nearly 17 million cars off the road. And in 2013, wind displaced SO2 and NO2 emissions, achieving approximately a 2% and 4% reduction, respectively. The economic impacts of wind are also broadly spread across the country. In 2013, the wind industry supported more than 50,000 jobs, with a supply chain of more than 560 facilities spread across 43 states. These jobs are in states both with and without actual wind deployment. In developing this project, DOE wanted to envision a future where wind was a part of the average American's everyday life and could coexist with all of the various missions of the nation. They envisioned broader wind deployment, including smaller distributed wind near homes and workplaces, offshore wind for coastal states, and land-based utility-scale wind in new regions of the United States. DOE also wanted to document the history and progress of wind technology in the U.S. To learn more, watch this video to appreciate how far the turbine technology has come. In looking forward, DOE evaluated a range of variables that really have an impact in changing future deployment of wind. These include overall energy demand projections for the future and the path of wind technology development and cost reductions. DOE looked at all these variables to substantiate a vision that is grounded in an ambitious but achievable study scenario that would deliver wind's benefits to the entire country. The Vision Study scenario is designed to more than double from today's wind share to supply 10% of the nation's electricity demand by 2020, 20% wind by 2030, and 35% wind by 2050. The Wind Vision Study scenario supports achieving the President's goals of doubling renewables by 2020 and makes substantial contributions to the administration's CO2 reduction targets for 2030 and 2050. Executing the Vision Study scenario would sustain the domestic industry and supply chain at approximately 10 gigawatts per year demand in the near term, with significant growth potential in the out years as repowering opportunities emerge post-2030. The Vision Study scenario would roughly double wind generation by 2020. By 2030, wind could be deployed in all 50 states, with more than 30 states in the 1 gigawatt and over club. By 2050, wind could be supplying the nation with 35% of its energy requirements. The nation faces serious challenges in meeting the energy demand and balancing other social and environmental challenges. Water scarcity out west. Public health issues in cities, such as asthma. The challenges of job creation and economic development. And global challenges like climate change all underscore the importance of shifting towards a clean energy economy. With these headwinds in mind, DOE made a calculation of the costs and benefits of wind power a cornerstone for their Wind Vision project. When it comes to greenhouse gas emissions reductions, wind is an essential player for meeting the nation's greenhouse gas goals. The Wind Vision study scenario could reduce electric sector CO2 emissions by roughly 9% in 2020, 23% in 2030, and 26% by 2050. But it's hard to appreciate those percentage reductions in tons of CO2. What do those types of greenhouse gas reductions translate to? The Wind Vision project followed the Interagency Working Group's Social Cost of Carbon methodology in order to monetize the benefits of carbon reductions, and found that the Wind Vision study scenario could deliver an estimated $520 billion in avoided damages by 2050, roughly the equivalent of 4.2 cents per kilowatt hour benefit, equaling incredible savings for the world. Reductions in greenhouse gases are a global benefit wind power delivers, whereas water is typically a much more local and regional issue. Wind is much less water-intensive than conventional power generation sources, like nuclear, coal, and natural gas. Water scarcity varies by region, but regardless of location, wind's water footprint delivers compelling value to Americans. The Wind Vision study scenario could reduce electric sector water consumption by approximately 6% in 2020, 16% in 2030, and up to 28% in 2050. Saving up to 336 billion gallons by 2050. That's the equivalent of 500,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools worth of saved water. The water savings will be valued differently in different regions, but in places like the dry West, where water is a precious commodity, every drop saved is appreciated. The Department of Energy is excited about the possible public health and ecosystem benefits they analyzed for the Wind Vision study. They know that sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, mercury, and other conventional power plant air pollutants have created numerous unintended consequences in the environment, ranging from increased incidences of children with asthma to fish with unhealthy levels of mercury in PCBs. When sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, and PM2.5 emissions impacts are monetized, the Wind Vision study scenario could potentially provide savings of between $16 to $103 billion in avoided damages by 2050, truly delivering benefits to future generations. This benefit is the equivalent to a 0.1 to 0.8 cents per kilowatt hour emissions benefit from wind. Finally, jobs within the Wind Vision study scenario would be spread across the country, and that economic impact ripples through communities, creating jobs at restaurants, gas stations, and grocery stores. By 2020, DOE's study scenario would result in 139,000 wind-related jobs, more than doubling from today. By 2030, the Wind Vision study scenario would result in more than 230,000 wind-related jobs and 175,000 jobs induced from the economic impacts of wind development. In 2050, the Wind Vision study scenario would create an estimated 400,000 wind-related jobs and 295,000 induced jobs in communities with wind deployment. However, this Wind Vision scenario does come at a cost, but many will be surprised by the price tags. DOE found that electricity prices increased by less than 1% in 2020 to reach 10% wind energy. In 2030, the Wind Vision scenario would result in approximately a 1% increase in electricity prices. But by 2050, analysis finds that 35% wind could yield a price savings of roughly 3%, or a $4 per megawatt hour decline in prices. Of course, these findings are dependent on future fossil fuel prices, so there are a range of scenarios in the analysis. System costs estimate cumulative costs from 2013 to 2050 for capital expenditures, operations, and management and fuel costs across the entire power sector. The nation will have to make investments to meet future energy demands with or without wind on the grid. Renewables like wind do entail significant upfront costs, but the long-term savings in reduced fuel consumption justifies the near-future investment. The DOE study found that the Wind Vision Study scenario does not make significant changes incrementally in system costs between now and 2050, and in fact, achieves about a 3% or $150 billion in savings, primarily due to reduced fossil fuel consumption. So, how can the U.S. get to that point? That's the question DOE considered when developing ideas for the Wind Vision's roadmap chapter. There should be a continued push for wind technology cost competitiveness and cost parity. The industry should maintain its domestic supply chain and deliver competitive prices to U.S. customers. Offshore wind industry efforts need to launch successfully in this country and bring affordable wind power to the nearby coastal states. The nation's transmission infrastructure needs to be modernized and expanded for all energy technologies, not just for wind only. Regulatory bodies, non-governmental organizations, and developers can work together to create efficient, sensible permitting procedures, while still ensuring that project development remains considerate of local communities and ecosystems. While the Wind Vision study was led by DOE, the reality is that over 200 people across more than 75 different organizations contributed to the analysis and drafting of the report. The Department of Energy is proud to share these preliminary findings with the public and wants to begin the conversation for how they, along with the help of the American people, could make this vision a reality. Look for the published final report reality. Look for the published final report on the website soon. Thank you.